Hey, what's going on, guys? So this is a video that I'm very excited to record. It is not going to be the greatest quality in the world, but this is just too good not to share. So I'm going to use the equipment that I have to be able to make this happen. And as you tell by the title of the video, this is about something that Apple has recently rolled out. They announced this at WWDC this year, where they announced that they were going to start adding some features to the AirPods Pro, and this is specific to AirPods Pro. They're going to add some features to AirPods Pro that would shake up the hearing aid industry quite a bit. Now, I don't know how much you know. If you're watching this video, you probably are like me. You probably have some moderate to mild hearing loss and have struggled with the cost of hearing aids here in the United States. A decent pair of hearing aids in the United States will cost you $2,000 plus on the cheap end. A pair with Bluetooth and some of the more modern features are running $3,000 to $4,000. And unfortunately, the hearing aid industry has been controlled exclusively by the medical industry here in the U.S. And it's not an industry that has been commonly supported by, insurance companies and other companies that would normally subsidize the cost of these devices. So, in short, there are a lot of people that have a need for hearing aids that can't afford them, and they've gone often to devices, and I actually have one here. Let me pull it out while I'm talking. Devices that are often marketed as hearing aids, but are what's really known as personal hearing amplifiers. And these hearing amplifiers are often amplifying all frequencies. And sometimes they have features, and like this is one here that I bought a while back. This is made in China. You can see that on the box there. And you can see there's PSAP, personal hearing amplifier. And it is a pretty decent little device here. You can see that it came in its own little box, and they're not rechargeable. It does use, it's an in-ear type device. It looks very much like a hearing aid, and this one is very expensive. It was $110. It actually supports three different levels of frequency, three different types of enhancement. It'll enhance low frequencies, all frequencies, or high frequencies. Unfortunately, I tried it and wore it for a few days, and it gave me a very bad headache. I have an equal in both ears, but a pretty common type of hearing loss where the upper frequencies are lost. So things like birds singing, crickets at night, and speech are affected. And speech is one of the worst things because higher pitched letters, and there are letters that have kind of a higher pitch, higher frequency part of them that makes them inaudible if you can't hear the frequency. So you basically you find yourself saying what, huh? And you find yourself reading lips, and yeah, it's not fun. And with my children and my wife, I'm often having to ask them to repeat themselves, and it can become frustrating. And in general, it makes life less enjoyable, especially if you like to spend times outdoors. You can't hear things like water running and bird singing. That's it can be difficult. It can be hard. And often you don't know what you're missing because you can't hear what you're missing. So Apple, a little bit of history. Earlier in the year, the FDA made it legal for companies to start making aftermarket hearing aids. So they actually put the hearing aid industry in kind of a flux, where there are some manufacturers that are starting to take some of the hearing aid specific features and market them over the counter. And I don't know if Apple actually is planning to go even deeper in the hearing aid industry, but this feature is an indicator that they might. So it brings me to this. AirPods Pro. AirPods Pro are awesome. They have, and this is a terrible camera on my MacBook Pro here, but AirPods Pro have a impressive set of technology features, technological features and advancements. They have a chip that's dedicated to processing onboard sound with transparency mode. And transparency mode is basically a feature, if you're not familiar with it, where you can put the headphones in your ear, and as you you can turn on transparency mode and it passes the sound through the microphones into your ear. And this is an amazing feature because it is indistinguishable from the outside sounds that you're taking in. And normally in the past, it would take the sounds from the outside, put them into your ear exactly as you would hear them without the headphones in. So if you have a hearing loss, normally it would be indistinguishable because it wasn't changing the frequencies at all as they come into the AirPods. It wasn't making any processing changes. It was putting it into your ear like it was hearing it. So in WWDC, it announced some features called hearing accommodations. So hearing accommodations is, I can actually show you here. Let's go into the settings, all right, and where you would find this as I scroll here through here. So you go into settings, you go to accessibility, all right, and if you have your AirPods Pro connected, which I'm going to connect them now, all right, and once again, I apologize about the quality. I will do my best to make this. You see AirPods are listed there, and down at the bottom, you have what's called audio accessibility settings, all right? And as you see here, you have mono audio, you know, the normal stuff, but up the top, you have headphone accommodations. Now, this is new to iOS 14. And to be specific, this is the newest version of iOS. I'm currently on the beta. They just rolled out with the final beta yesterday. So the recording of this is September 16th. The recording of this video, September 16th, 2020, at the time of recording, they should have the final version of iOS 14 released by, I would assume, by next week, if not sooner. So you may very well already have iOS 14 on your device at the time of actually watching this video. So if you see here, there's this Audiogram feature I have on my screen. Now, this is a new feature to iOS 14 to where you can actually go up to custom audio setup, and it will basically, you can click continue, and it will ask you to choose, if you can see that there. All right, so that says Audiograms in white there. You can actually see it because of the camera. And this is my last, yesterday I did a new Audiogram. I'm say use Audiogram. And so it's, I don't have my headphones in right now, so it's just not actually allowing me to test it. I'm going to cancel that setup because I already have it in. That uses the Audiogram from the Apple Health. So inside of Apple Health, you actually have the option to set up an Audiogram in Apple Health, and that allows you to use an app like Mimi, which is what I used, to actually test your, use your AirPods Pro as your earphones. You put them in noise canceling mode, so it's like you're in a sound booth, and it takes you through a hearing test. And it's very accurate. I mean, it's very impressive. It comes out my Audiogram, and I'll actually pull up Mimi here so you can see. All right. And that's my current hearing results. And you see there it says moderate. If I actually click, it tells me, you know, that I have moderate hearing loss. My Audiogram, let me show you my Audiogram. This is my Audiogram. As you see there, it's got that classic dip. Now, it's only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 frequencies that it tests, but that's enough in my experience. 6 frequencies. A lot of these higher-end headphones actually have, they'll go up to 16 frequencies, and they get very, very detailed in the frequency loss. If you have moderate hearing loss, in my experience, these 6 frequencies are quite enough to actually get a pretty good enhancement to your hearing and correction to your hearing. So I did this audio test, took the Audiogram, and it saved the Audiogram, and you saw I have a few tests here. That was the one that was probably the most accurate. And you see they're all pretty close in their results. And what it does is inside of audio accessibility and headphone accommodations, it puts the Audiogram. And what that actually did before yesterday is that you had down at the bottom here, it applies to the phone and media. So your phone calls and your media, like music and movies, would sound amazing. It corrected the sounds, so it would increase the frequencies that you naturally aren't able to hear well. So it was super impressive. Like, music sounded like I haven't heard it sound like in years. All right, so Yesterday, when I put my AirPod in and it connects, you'll see that yesterday they added this feature here where it says apply to transparency mode. So if I click on transparency mode, you actually see now that it has custom transparency mode, and it allows me to change amplification, the balance, and it actually I can tweak the tone. So if my audiogram, if I've never worn hearing aids before and my audiogram is a little tinny, I can come in here and make it a little darker to make it a little more comfortable. I'm fine with it. Actually, yesterday, I just a little quick story. I did this, installed the update. I had to restart my phone, and I had my headphones in, and I had my window rolled down. And I live in the middle of a forest, and I have lots of birds and things that I normally couldn't hear. And when that turned on, and I had my headphones in, it was like the mute button was turned off on my ears. It was incredible. And the enhancement and the correction was perfect. And I can say from experience, I tested a pair of phonic head like $4,000 very high-end Bluetooth last year Bluetooth hearing aids, behind the ear hearing aids, and I hated them. They sounded terrible. They sounded they were programmed with my audiogram from a hearing test. But they sounded mechanical and tinny, and because they were behind the ear, it was very strange. Sounds were enhanced that behind my head. There was no directional sound. It was very uncomfortable. I can tell you that these, but they're in your ear, and because Apple has this, they have fine-tuned this technology where transparency mode was already perfect. It uses that transparency mode that they've already perfected to simply amplify the sounds based on your audiogram. It's better than any hearing aids I've ever used. And to put comparison here, these devices are 200. Well, I got these for $170. All right. I showed you that little amplifier that I bought. That was $100. For two of them, it would have been more expensive, and they're not rechargeable. You have the cost of batteries to consider there. $200 plus the cost of batteries for just personal hearing amplifiers that go in your ear. Now, they're more concealable, and there is a little bit of a paradigm shift here because people that want to start using these as hearing aids will wear their AirPods all the time. Now, there may be a social impact here. People may feel like you're being rude if you have your headphones in and you're talking to them. There may be a little bit of an impact there, but there's already a stigma about hearing aids anyway. So for a lot of people, this may be actually more accessible for them to wear hearing aids than say, or wear their AirPods than to feel uncomfortable and the stigma about wearing hearing aids. So just wearing one like I am right now, it's fantastic. Two of them is amazing. So there is that little bit of consideration. That if you're replacing your hearing aids with these or using these as hearing aids, there may be some appearance issues there. But outside of that, they're incredible. So I highly, highly, highly recommend that if you're considering buying AirPods Pro to use them as hearing aids, do it. You won't regret it. Just in the past 2 days that I've used these, I can already tell that this is going to be a life-changing thing for me in times where I need to be able to hear. I watched a movie last night. I didn't have to read the subtitles. I could actually hear what they were saying. I play guitar. I was playing my guitar, and there's no lag whatsoever. I was able to play guitar and hear the tones in the guitar better than I've heard in years, if not better than ever. And there is one minor thing that will take some getting used to. If you've ever used hearing aids, there's a thing called the occlusion effect. So when you have something in your ears and you talk or you chew, there's that feeling of like you're in a bucket. That happens with anything that you have in your ear. So if you have hearing aids, often you'll get that occlusion effect with just regular expensive hearing aids. So there is, you do have to be aware that there will be an occlusion effect with these. And because there is a really tight seal in your ear with these silicone tips, there will be a little bit of an occlusion effect when you speak. The longer you wear them, the more natural that will sound. That occlusion effect is not just because you have something in your ear, but it's also because you're hearing your voice and frequencies of your voice that you haven't heard in a long time. So don't give up on them with the occlusion effect. Just take a break. Pull one out, you put leave one in. Eventually you'll get used to it, and you'll not even remember that they're in your ears. That happened to me the last time I wore a pair of hearing aids. It did go away eventually. The occlusion effect wasn't as noticeable because I gotten used to it. There is also the comfort issue. I do recommend, if you're going to wear these for a long period, to get the memory foam that you're silicone, but the silicone tips that they come with may work well for you. But for me, I've ordered a pair of the memory foam tips to seal a little better in my ear. These do have a history of falling out of my ears. So I do have strange ears. So these have a history of just eventually when I'm chewing or talking without warning, they'll just slide out of my ear. So I got some memory foam tips from eBay for like $8 that will hopefully fix that for me. And I can wear these when I'm being more active. But anyway, I hope this video was super helpful for you. And if it has, leave a comment down below. I would love to hear your stories about how this has changed your life, or about your stories about how this will impact your life in the future if you're looking to buy some.